Although I'm into a more tactile coloring experience versus digital, and I'd love it if you would color in my books, I wanted to see for myself what it's like to color in a digital coloring app. So here is a review. I hope you like it. Hi, it's Dia. Today I'm reviewing the free coloring app called Happy Color. Just go to the App Store, click, and it will upload. And there are quite a bit of pages. I was actually really impressed. I was surprised. I didn't quite know what the rare meant, if there was only a few allowed. Okay, so the first thing that happened, I went to select one and it showed me an ad. And then 30 seconds later, I was able to click out. So I chose this frog. On the bottom, you see all those colors. And when you click one, so let's say I clicked one, the color you clicked gets darker. So it's almost like color by number, except rather than saying one or two or three, the areas turn gray. And it's actually kind of fun. It's mindless. There's really nothing to stress over until they ask you to find areas that are so itty bitty that it's first of all hard to find. And second of all, I couldn't figure out if it was unnecessary for the image or not, because some of the lines and some of the little spaces are right next to one another and they're exactly the same color. Oh, so you see that little bubble right there? I ignored it for the first couple times. So if you're looking for something for a long time, that little bubble comes up. And what it's offering you is a chance for help. So if you click the bubble, an ad pops up, but I'll show you that later. It also offers, if you watch the ad, it offers you two more options for help. So these itty bitty teeny tiny areas that you literally can't even see, they'll focus in on for you. Oh, there it is. They'll focus in on for you, and then you have an option to allow it to help you or not. So up to this point, I was having fun. The colors were a little bit bigger. Now you can see how many times I'm clicking that one color. And yes, it was fun, but I literally couldn't find what to do. So okay, let's say you're on color 4. If you want to move to color 5, you can. Color 4 will still be there. But color 4 won't go away unless you finish all the areas that are supposed to be done with color 4. So it gets a little frustrating and a little tiny bit annoying. But if you're willing to put up with the ads and hit that little bubble, you can get all the help you want. So after being frustrated for quite a bit for that one color, I clicked that bubble and it brought me to an ad. Now, I moved right through it, so you didn't have to sit through it, but each of those ads lasts for 30 seconds. And I get it, you're not paying for it. So they have to pay for the app some way. To me, that's worth it, because some of the apps are a lot of money, and you can start collecting these apps. First of all, they take up space on your phone, and second of all, the cost seems like it's nothing, $2, $3, even $10, but after a while it starts to add up. So this was, in my humble opinion, a very nice free app. You can go back and forth through the colors as often as you want. So if you get tired of doing the greens and you want to move forward to the pinks or back to the blues, anything you like, any pattern you like. Also, that can be helpful if you find one of the colors that fills up a bigger area. Eventually, the blank spaces get to be less and less, so that's a bit of a help. So the good points of this app are the pictures are very pretty. I was really impressed, and I scrolled through the pictures for a long time, and it never ended. So I don't know how many are offered, but it seems like it's endless. I'm sure there's an end to it. The colors are beautiful. There's no timer to frustrate you, so it's not in game format. I was really happy to see that. You can stop in the middle of a picture, and it automatically saves. And when you open up and you want to start again, you can start right where you left off. It takes a nice long time to finish an image. So it isn't just, you know, toot sweet, you're finished and you're going to go through another one. You're going to go through this whole app in a week. I think if somebody's really into coloring, you can do it on your iPad, which is what I did because I found it to be a little tiny on my iPhone, and I have an iPhone 8 Plus, which is pretty big. The end result is really satisfying because it's so pretty, and it replays your coloring in the exact order you did it, and I'll show you that at the end. There are a couple not so good points. The ads are long, and if you do want help, you have to sit through one of the ads. Like I said, some of the areas are very tiny, a little bit frustrating to find, but they do offer help if you can deal with the ads, and the help is offered often. So I moved forward a little bit and I wanted to show you the help. So I took the help and see, it moves forward and it shows you, I should say, not even forward, it just gets bigger. And I eventually did figure out you can make it bigger. So you can figure out those tiny areas much better. So here it is in replay. This is that satisfying part that I was telling you about. I don't know why I like to watch it. I watched it a couple times. It's fun. Now, another really good point about this is that it shows you such a nice method to color. Here it is. It's in an orderly fashion. So when you go back in at the beginning or at the end, or if you want to open it again, look at all these images. Now, there's some that say rare. I'm not quite sure what that means. Oh, see, now when I clicked another one, another ad opened, but I was able to click out of that one really fast. Here's a Disney picture, probably geared more for kids. It's a little bit easier. The thing that got me really happy was this. Some of the images say blend, and you can see that there's not as many lines, and it's very painterly. And about a minute or two into this, I realized that this is a picture, I should say it's a painting, a very famous painting from 1654 by Karel Fabritius, and it's called The Goldfinch. And that's the actual, well, that's a picture of the painting, and you can see how close it is. And I really enjoyed that because you couldn't even really tell in the beginning what the image was. It just looked like very sketchy outlines. There's also a book called The Goldfinch. It's a huge bestseller. I read that about a year ago. I'll put the link for everything below. I think if you enjoy sweeping epic novels, it was a gorgeous book about art and life.
So this is available on Android and Apple, links below. And although I don't think it in any way replaces that amazing feeling of our art supplies in our hands, it's a fun on-the-go coloring-ish experience. So thank you for watching, and let me know if you'd like me to review more coloring apps. And I will see you soon. Thanks for watching. I hope you are all healthy, and I definitely give this a fun thumbs up. Bye.